My dear brothers and sisters, these days most of you are following up with this grand visitation of Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam in Karbala. This unprecedented gathering of millions of people, over 10 million people, some estimates say 20 million people, have gathered to visit Al-Imam Al-Hussein in Karbala. This amazing ziyarah, this amazing visitation is one of the great blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised an immense reward for those who visit Al-Imam Al-Hussein salawatullahi alayhi. I would like to share with you some of the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives to the visitors of Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam. One hadith states, إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا. If Allah loves a person, wants to honor that person, what does he do to him? قَذَفَ فِي قَلْبِهِ حُبَّ الْحُسَيْنِ وَحُبَّ زِيَارَتِهِ. اللهم صلي على محمد وعلى محمد. If Allah loves a person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put the love of Imam Hussein and the love of his ziyarah in his heart. How lucky are those who truly love the Imam and make an effort to visit the Imam alayhi salam. It is a great status that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives to those whom he loves. Another hadith tells us more about the rewards for the ziyarah of Al-Imam Al-Hussein. The one who walks to the grave of Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam, wanting to visit him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him for every step the reward of one accepted Hajj and one accepted Umrah. And one hadith states 1,000 accepted Hajj and accepted Umrah. This is the reward for the ziyarah of Al-Imam Al-Hussein. You may be wondering, why? Is this an exaggeration? Why all this reward? The reward of one accepted Hajj or 1,000 accepted pilgrimages? My dear brothers and sisters, who saved the Hajj for us? Who saved the religion of Islam? Through whose efforts did this religion survive? And you know, Imam Hussein alayhi salam, he was in Mecca during the days before the Hajj, before he went to Iraq. On which day did he leave Mecca? Yawm al-Tarwiyah. That's the 8th of the Hijjah. That's one day before Arafah. Everyone was coming to Mecca, the Imam alayhi salam, one day before the Hajj starts, he leaves and he goes to Karbala. Why? He's sending a powerful statement. What is the point of this Hajj under a dictator like Yazid ibn Muawiyah? When you've abandoned your obligation, when you Muslims have deviated from the message of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, and you gather here to do the Hajj, what point is that? Who are you worshipping? So the Imam alayhi salam made a powerful statement that your Hajj has no value under oppression and injustice if you stay silent. If you accept the status quo and you accept the evil leadership of those rulers. And the Imam leaves one day before the Hajj starts. He could have stayed a few more days. He could have. But the Imam made a statement. The Imam was making a statement that I am rising to save this Hajj for future generations. Because the evil ones had come to destroy the Hajj. So yes, don't be surprised if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the visitors of Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam such an immense reward. Because by going to Karbala, we are remembering the values of Imam Hussein. Every noble virtue and value you find embodied in Karbala. Honesty, integrity, courage, patience, humbleness. You find all of these virtues in the land of Karbala. By visiting the Imam alayhi salam, we are renewing our allegiance to the Imam. We're pledging him allegiance. Oh Aba Abdullah, we will continue your message. Don't be surprised if there is such an immense reward. Another hadith in examining the rewards and the benefits of visiting Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam states the one who visits Al-Hussein salawatullahi alayhi, Allah will prolong his life, Number two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase his sustenance. And number three, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive his sins. All these benefits for visiting the grandson of the Messenger of Allah. The Imam in one hadith says it's an obligation. It's an obligation on every believer to visit Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam. The Imam says if you can once a year, go once a year. If you can go twice a year, go twice a year. Don't be surprised when you hear all of these benefits. Remember, the Prophet after 23 years, after all those efforts and sacrifices, he asked for one thing from his community, from Muslims. One thing. قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا Except one thing. What did he ask from people? الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى To show their love for the family of the Prophet ﷺ. That's the only thing that he asked for. That's the price that you pay for the religion of Islam. Because the product that the Prophet offered, he brought to us is Islam. What's the ajr? What's the price that you have to pay for this Islam? It's not free. Who told you Islam is free? The Quran uses the word ajr. The word ajr means there's a fee that you have to pay. There's a price that you have to pay. It's not free. This great religion is not free. The price that you pay is loving and following the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى Are we paying this price? When you visit Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam, you are showing that love to the family of the Prophet. You are offering your condolences to the Prophet. You are thanking Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam for his sacrifices. So don't be surprised if there is all this reward. Because you're paying the price for the religion of Islam. And the religion of Islam is priceless. Can you put a value to the religion of Islam? So if you're paying that price for a religion that's priceless, that's unlimited in its value, then the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you is also unlimited. We have many, many narrations, my dear brothers and sisters, about the visitation of Al-Imam Al-Hussein. Let's pay more attention to this visitation. Let's try to visit the Imam alayhi salam as much as we can. I know many of you have had the honor of going to Karbala, but try as much as you can to visit the Imam alayhi salam at least once a year. This is the least thing that we can do, to thank the Imam alayhi salam for his sacrifices. You know Al-Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam, how much he would pray for the visitors of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. Muawiyah ibn Wahab, one of the companions of Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam, he says, once I went to visit Imam al-Sadiq. I was told to enter. I went into the room. I saw the Imam alayhi salam in the state of sujood and he was crying. The Imam alayhi salam was crying very genuinely in a heartbreaking tone. The Imam alayhi salam was crying. I want to share with you the very words of Al-Imam As-Sadiq salawatullahi alayhi. He says, I came near to him and I heard him state the following. He says, he was speaking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, Ya man khassana bil karama, wa khassana bil wasiyya, wa wa'adana shafa'a, wa a'tana ilma ma mada wa ma baqi. He says, oh Allah, who has given us the Ahlul Bayt, such a high status, and you've given us the power of shafa'a, you've given us unseen knowledge. Then he does a prayer that's truly powerful. He says, اغفر لي ولأخواني الذين قصدوا قبر أبي عبد الله الحسين. Oh Allah, forgive me and forgive my brothers who are visiting the grave of Imam al-Hussein. Al-Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam considers the one who visits Al-Imam al-Hussein to be his brother. Allahu Akbar. Is there a status greater than this? Then he begins to pray for them. And then Muawiyah ibn Wahab, he says, I heard him state the following. He said, فَرْحَمْ تِلْكَ الْوُجُوهَ الَّتِي قَدْ غَيَّرَتْهَا الشَّمْسِ Oh Allah, have mercy on those faces who have been affected by the sun when they go for ziyarah. وَارْحَمْ تِلْكَ الْخُدُودِ الَّتِي تَقَلَّبَتْ عَلَىٰ قَبْرِ أَبِي عَبْدِ اللَّهِ. Oh Allah, have mercy on those cheeks that went to the grave of Hussein and they humbled themselves by placing their cheek on the soil of Karbala. Oh Allah, have mercy on them. Muawiyah ibn Wahab says, I was shocked. When he was finished, I told him, Imam, all this reward for the visitors of Hussein? How come? He told him, Oh Muawiyah, let me tell you. Let me tell you more. Don't you want to be included in the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Imam Ali and Lady Fatima? They pray for everyone who goes and visits al-Imam al-Hussein salawatullahi alayhi. Let's appreciate the ziyarah, my dear brothers and sisters. And do our best to try to make it at least once a year. Al-Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam says it's an obligation on the believers to visit him once a year at least. I know time is valuable. Some of you might have security concerns. But do you know how the ziyarah survived? Do you know the previous ones, how they made the ziyarah? Too often we forget. It was through their sacrifices that the message of Ahlul Bayt stayed alive. The evil tyrants of the time, they tried to extinguish the light of Imam Hussein. At the time of Al-Mutawakkil Al-Abbasi, you know what they would do to the visitors? They would install checkpoints and have guards. You were banned from visiting the grave of Imam Hussein. If you wanted to visit al-Imam al-Hussein, you had to pay. Initially, they would collect money. They found that many people are willing to pay money. Then they imposed a new type of tax. If you wanted to visit the grave of Imam Hussein, you know what you had to offer? They would cut your right hand. The guard would be standing there at the time of Al-Mutawakkil Al-Abbasi, and he would say to the visitors of Imam Hussein, fine, you want to go? Give us your hand. We'll cut your hand. One man came to that checkpoint. And the guard told him, give me your hand. He gave him his left arm. He told him, no, give me your right hand. If you want to visit Hussein, give me your right hand. He showed him his right arm. He told him, last year, you cut my right arm. Here, take my left arm. See, I don't have a right arm. This is how they sacrifice to visit. Alhamdulillah, these days it's safe. There aren't really serious concerns. Millions and millions of people go and they return safely. What excuse do we have, my dear brothers and sisters? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect the visitors of al-Imam al-Hussein salawatullahi alayhi. And to have them return to their homes safely. May Allah accept their ziyarah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us this great blessing of going for ziyarah, inshallah, even before next year, from now till the next Arba'een. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the opportunity to go on another occasion to visit al-Imam al-Hussein salawatullahi alayhi. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa alihi al-tayyibin al-tahirin. الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن علي ولي الله أشهد أن عليا أمير المؤمنين حجة الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح حي على خير العمل حي على خير العمل قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله وجهت وجهي للذي فطر السماوات والأرض حنيفا مسلما وما أنا من المشركين إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين لا شريك له وبذلك أمرت وأنا من المسلمين. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط